Hello dear traders, it's Petko Aleksandrov from EA Forex Academy, and in this lecture I will continue with the Monte Carlo robustness tool that we have in Expert Advisor Studio. So let me get into it. I have some strategies here that are memorized into the collection. I will remove them. Now Monte Carlo, you can find it right here just below strategy when you click on strategy. But I don't have any strategy at the moment, so let me generate quickly some, and I will stay with dollar Canadian on M15. I will have the range from 10 to 100 for stop loss and take profit. And as generator settings here, let's use the acceptance criteria. In this case, I will click on it, and here I will add some criteria for the complete backtest. Now if you're using in sample and out of sample, you can add different criteria. This is what I was talking about in my previous course for the top 10 Aussie dollar expert advisors. But here I will not use it. I will put some criteria for the complete backtest. So I always start with minimum backtest quality, and I keep it on 98. So this is a criteria. If our historical data is fine, and what is the backtest quality before, it was called ambiguous bars. So here the software detects the bars or the candlesticks that we have in MetaTrader, where for example we have an entry, okay, let's say on the opening of this bar, let me zoom it, or any bar, doesn't matter really. On any bar, we have the opening, for example, here, and then we have a stop loss, and then we have a take profit. And with MetaTrader, we have the opening, the high, the low, and the close. These are the four values, but we really don't know what happened inside the bar. And if we have such a bar where we have the stop loss and the take profit within this bar, the backtest will take it as a negative, as it was hitting the stop loss. Now the difference is when we are doing backtest with MetaTrader is that it will take the take profit. Okay, it will give you the more positive result, which I really don't like, because I prefer to see the negative result instead of the positive result. Because if we have many bars with this strategy, this one for example here or anywhere else, and our backtest shows us that it always takes the take profit, obviously this could be misleading, and it could be the case that it will hit more the stop loss. Okay, so MetaTrader takes the positive, and EA Studio here is skeptical and takes the stop loss, which I believe is the better method as well. So we can say that we see more skeptical result for the strategy while backtesting it. Anyway, I keep it minimum backtesting quality 98, and I will add minimum count of trades, what I was talking about earlier. I want to have at least 350 trades. So each strategy that will be generated, I want to see at least 350 trades executed in the backtest. Okay, I will add as well the profit factor, one of my favorite criteria, and I will increase it to 1.2. So the profit factor for the newbie traders, this is the ratio of the net profit versus the net loss. And then I will add the minimum error squared, something new with the strategy builder, which I really like to use. And for example, here I will go with 60. Now error squared is a little bit more complicated. More information about it in our forum. Let me just show it quickly to you. There is one section called updates in EA Studio. Sorry, it's EA Studio updates. When I click on it, you will see here some videos and explanations about the error squared and about some other features. This is about the backtesting statistics, and you see there are many comments, and I explain in details about the new features. And let me just show you where is the error squared, right here on the second page. So this is a video, if you click on it, that you can watch for free, and below are explanations. So simply words, the error squared gives us equity line that is very close to such a regression line, And the higher value we have for the R squared means that we have more points on the line. The more the equity line is far away from the line, or we have a dramatic drawdown or so on, then we will have a lower R squared. But here is in details, and for me it's very interesting, especially if you want to analyze your strategies in details. Okay, so you can read it here in our forum, it's free, and you can learn more about it. Okay, I will leave now these acceptance criteria, these four things: the minimum backtest quality, the minimum count of trades, minimum profit factor, and minimum R squared. Now, going back to the generator, I will press on start, and you will see now what is the difference. I have many strategies calculated. You can see hundreds of strategies calculated, but still no any strategy is shown, because it filters all these strategies with this acceptance criteria that I have selected over here. All right, I will just pause the video now to have some results, and I will explain about Monte Carlo. Thank you. Up, actually, here it is, guys, right here before pausing the video. I had one strategy already calculated. Okay, so I will take it as an example. I will click on it. And you see this strategy uses moving average, force index for entry conditions, and the Bollinger Bands as an exit condition. We have stop loss and a take profit. And here is the balance chart. All right, now going to the Monte Carlo, you see that I have market variations, execution problems, and strategy variations. So we can say this is a simulator. On some places you can see it as trading simulator or Forex trading simulator. Basically what it does, it performs variety of backtests with different variations. Now I like to use the strategy variation, so a randomized indicator parameters, which means that the software does exactly the same what I showed to you on the MetaTrader, where I was changing the parameters for the indicators and I was doing a backtest. Okay, randomized indicator parameters. One more time, it will perform different tests, different backtests with different parameters, with randomized parameters. And normally when I run the Monte Carlo, I want to see at least 80% of the simulations to be profitable. Now let's concentrate only on this one, randomized indicator parameters. I will click on start, and you see that this strategy had 15 out of 20 validated tests. So this is below my criteria of 80%, which would be 16 out of 20, okay? You can see here are the results for the different backtests that were made. Now you can set it in options, you can set what would be the change for the parameters in the indicators, the deviation range in steps. I keep it here as a default, okay? I really don't touch these things, guys, because they are set in a very nice way, and I have tested it a lot, and for me it works just fine if it is in this way. Of course you can play around with that, but I'm not going into details. It's a little bit more complicated and it's not really the subject of this course, and I want to keep it simple, and I want to explain what is the most important in this robustness tool. Okay, now if I go to randomize backtest starting bar, it will perform variety of tests that are starting from different point in the past. Okay, they will not start from 16th of October 2017, but they will start later on. Okay, and if I click on start, you will see what happens. The starting points are here in this range, and you can see that actually the strategy continues to perform well. Doesn't matter when we will place it on the chart, and this is exactly the point of having this test, because when we create expert advisor, we test it over the historical data, but we will place it trading on the MetaTrader in a future moment, okay? And here this simulation shows us that doesn't matter when we will place it on the chart, it doesn't fail, okay? Even it was placed on a different moment from the one that we used while generating the strategy. And actually these tests prove something very important, that this strategy is not over optimized for this period of time, okay? Because if the generator over optimized it exactly from starting here, let's say in October 2017 till the moment it found these best parameters exactly for this period of time, then here with this test I will see a dramatic loss when the strategy starts somewhere over here in a later moment from this moment here. Alright, and let's take some of the other strategies, because you can see many were generated, some with very nice equity lines. I will click on this one and let's go to the Monte Carlo. I will perform these two tests and I click on start and you can see I have 17 out of the 20. Alright, so here I get a little bit more positive results. And this is exactly what I want to see, okay? Strategies that were having simulations with randomized indicator parameters and were having simulations with different backtest starting bar. Okay, now above we have market variations, which means randomized history data, randomized spread. If your spread is floating a lot, you can check and perform robustness with the spread. So if I click on start, you will see that this strategy keeps performing well, even the spread is a little bit different. Now if I have randomized history data, I will click on start again, the strategy performs well. This normally is used if you have problems with a huge spread or floating spread, or you have problems with your historical data. And then you have execution problems like randomly skip positions, randomly close position. It will perform you such tests and simulations to see how the strategy will perform if you randomly close position. Now, I don't test this because simply in algorithmic trading, what is my goal is to do it 100% fully automatically, okay? I don't interfere the expert advisors, I don't close the positions and I don't remove them from the chart for no reason. So I don't test these execution problems. And if you have execution problems with your broker, like huge slippage, or they close your positions for some reason, then you better change your broker. Okay, so these are the two Monte Carlo tests that I am doing, these two simulations which are very interesting to me, and for me they just make sense because they change the parameters for the indicators, and using the last one we test the expert advisor or the strategy if it has started at a different moment. Alright guys, this is the Monte Carlo. You can see how many strategies are already generated, some of them with very nice backtest output and very nice equity lines. So this is about the Monte Carlo, very useful analytic tool that we have with EA Studio. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask me. If you see this for the first time, I'm sure it's a little bit more complicated, but if there is something unclear, really don't hesitate to ask me. I will answer any question. Thank you for watching and I will see you in the next lecture. Cheers.